So when teachers are considering the use of AI in assessment tasks, the really important sort of first question is, what is it that the student is actually being assessed on? What are the learning outcomes that we're trying to assess here? And to what extent is AI relevant or irrelevant to that outcome? So trying to make sure that we're always thinking about, are we looking at how well students can use AI in this particular task? Or are we looking at how well students can think their way through things without AI? So they're the fundamental characteristics. The reasons for the six categories of permissible use of AI at UNSW are really based on a couple of core concepts. The first and really important one is that students need to know what's being asked of them in an assessment in order for them to actually successfully complete that assessment. So it's just part of the package of instructions or the brief that the students get when they get their assessment. They need to understand what they're supposed to be doing and what scope they're given for creativity and freedom. So that's the first important thing. The second thing was to try to make sure that across the university, students have some sort of consistent set of wording or a consistent set of categories that they can apply across assessments. Because although we tend to teach our students in only one or two courses and in our own school, students are enrolled across multiple schools, across multiple degrees, and trying to build some level of consistency in the way in which they understand what's expected of them is really critical. So then when you get down into the six categories themselves, you've got categories at either end, one which is sort of an exam type category or a musical performance type category where AI couldn't possibly be involved. And so you've got either no AI, which is the you're not allowed to use it category, which is sort of for exams. And then we've got the it doesn't really matter, it's not applicable category for things like musical performance. And then in the middle, we've got a set of categories which are really looking at the way in which, or the levels of interaction with AI that the students are encouraged to do. And we're trying to mix in those categories, not just permissions, but also indications, signposts to the way in which they should be approaching their learning in this assessment. So if the category is simple editing assistance, this is really saying to the students, this is an old school assessment. This is an assessment where we just want you to write it using word processing software and not really using AI at all. If we're saying to them, you can use it for preparation prior to the writing, what we're saying is use AI in the way in which you use it probably every day, which is as an inspiration, as a way of trying to get you to think about things. Then the third category is have a go at it yourself. Back yourself to do a first version, and then when you've done that first version, then use AI to make your response more polished. And that's really using AI as a coach. So you try it yourself, and the AI is there as a tutor on the side to help you make your response more effective. And then the final category is the AI as a partner category, where we're actually requiring you to use AI as part of the assessment, because what we really want to assess here is your ability to use the AI tools in completing that assessment. I think the question of what's good AI use in an assessment really depends on the assessment. It really comes back to what is the learning outcome that we're trying to achieve with this assessment, and what is it that we're really trying to assess. So a good use of AI is using AI in a way that supports the student to achieve that learning outcome. I think one of the sort of fundamentals that we should always assume is that students are using AI. And they're using it for note-taking, they're using it for study techniques, they're using it for initial inspiration and research. So a really good use of AI recognises that that's the reality of the world that we live in. You know, you wouldn't ban the use of Google in searching for research materials. So similarly, I think we can't really consider that students should not use the tools that they have with them. So we need to incorporate that in. So the really important thing then around assessment is, how do we design an assessment in such a way that takes account of that, but also stretches the students and asks them to think critically about things and to be critical of the outputs of the AI, so that the AI is a tool rather than a crutch.